Back in Power BI, we continue to learn Power BI Desktop. And in today's video, we are going to show you some techniques to make a button so that way you can switch from different visuals using the button. So we're going to switch from total sales to total orders. And all you need to do is just click on the button. And we're going to show you how to do this in Power BI. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, switching visuals by clicking on a button is one of those report techniques that you're going to want to learn how to use, because as a report designer, you're always trying to design reports that are user-friendly. And some people that are consuming the reports, they're going to want to see specific information that relates to their department. So in this example, we're going to show you how to use buttons. You're going to learn about bookmarks. You're going to learn about some basic visualization techniques. But the main thing what we're going to be showing is you can have on one page, you can have a couple of buttons, and you could have as many buttons as you want. Maybe you want 3 buttons, 4 buttons. You could have different stages, but the user is going to see the button, and all they need to do is select what they want to do. So currently, you are looking at total sales by fiscal year. Maybe you want to see total orders. Now, the difference between looking at them on a same page is, remember, the less crowded your reports are and the more compact information they can see, it allows them to make decisions. So by having only one chart showing on this report, they can focus on orders. If they want to focus in on sales, they can see sales. So this is a very simple report. A lot of times you'll want to have multiple charts change, but in this example, we're going to show you how to do this with just one chart changing by clicking the button. We're going to be using the selection pane. We're going to use the bookmark pane. We're going to insert some buttons, and we're also going to create a couple of charts in this video. Remember, you can follow along. There will be a link below in the description to download the file if you do not have any data of your own. But the best way to learn Power BI is always use these techniques on your own data. So if you've currently got a Power BI report, you may want to just open that up and then follow along. So let's go and show you how to switch visuals with a button in Power BI. Back in Power BI, we continue to learn how to do reporting techniques. And in this video, just showed you how we are going to create the button so that you can change visuals in Power BI. You can follow along by downloading the AdventureWorks file. I don't want to spend too much time on downloading that file. If you watched other videos, you may already have the link. It's in the description below. And we're going to create 2 measures. All we're going to need is 2 measures for this video. Again, if you have your own data and you already have a model, you can open that file up and follow along as well. So the first measure you want to create is a total sales measure. This is going to be the sum of total sales. That is going to be total sales. Then you're going to create another measure called total orders. So 2 measures added to this file that is already built out. Again, the model has already been built. It's AdventureWorks Database 2020. Next, you're going to create a new page, and we're going to call this button visuals. And so now you have a blank page, and you're ready to start creating the 3-step process, really. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to create the visuals, then you're going to create the buttons, and then you're going to activate the buttons in Power BI. Now, if you're new to Power BI, in the last few years, Power BI has added a different look to the different data panes that are a visual. So if you are in the View menu, the first thing you're going to want to do is on the right-hand side, I see the Data View, you see the Build, and then you see the Format. Those three things are defaulted, and you can change those on your view menu. The one thing you want to do is you want to add your bookmarks by clicking on bookmarks, and that appears on the right-hand side as bookmarks. You also want to add your selection view. Those are not default. So now we can alter between the selection view and the bookmark view. And then the next thing you're going to want to do is on your pane manager, you currently have an option that only shows the active pane or always show the pane manager. And I switch this to always show pane manager. If you show only the active pane, then what happens is if you're on the bookmarks pane, you only see the selection pane. And then if you are on the selection pane, you don't see all of the different panes. So I'm going to have you select, uncheck, show only one active pane. So now when you go to the bookmarks, you can see that pane. When you go to the selection pane, you can see that pane. So that is how you're going to set up to start to work with the selection pane and the bookmark pane in Power BI. Switching visuals with a button. The first step in the process is we need to create the visuals that we want to use. Now, for this example, we are going to keep it very basic. We're going to have just two visuals. But again, you could use additional visuals. You could have more than two buttons. You could use an image for the button rather than a button that we're going to have just showing text. So different options. Once you've created your new page called Button Visuals, we're going to create the first visual, which is a clustered column chart. And we're going to add total sales. And then we're also going to add the physical year. So now we've got sales by year. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to copy that visual. Then we're going to select Control V. We're going to paste it. And this one is we're going to substitute total sales with total orders. So now we've got total orders by fiscal year. We've got total sales by fiscal year. If you go into your selection pane, if you select the selection pane, you see the layer order is named by the chart on the page. And once you start having a lot of visuals on a page, you're probably going to want to name these more intuitively. So we're going to select total sales, just the total sales state. Then if we select the total orders, that way it's a little bit more intuitive when you're looking at your layers. So now we've got total orders, we've got total sales, and if you look at the bookmark stage, we've got show sales and show orders as our two different stages. And we're going to show you how next. Next thing we're going to do is we've created the visuals. Now we want to create the buttons. Step two in the process of creating a button, so that way you can change the visual by clicking the button, we are going to go to the insert and you're going to select buttons. Now there's all different types of options. You can choose a left arrow, a right arrow, you've got information buttons, and as you start designing reports, you're going to use these buttons. We are going to select a blank button. We're going to move this button to more centered on the report. We're going to make it a little bit bigger. Next, when you select the button, if you right-click, you can choose format. And for the formatting, we're going to make just a couple of changes to the button. On the formatting button options, we are going to choose button style. We are going to change this to a pill style, and we're going to add some text. We're going to turn that on, and the text is going to be sales. We're going to make this 20-point font. And that is the only change we're going to make to this button. Now, the only other thing we're going to do is we're going to color code these. So that way, again, for the user, you want to make it easy and intuitive. So when they know when they're clicking on this, when they see a certain color, they know they're looking at sales. And when they see another color, they're looking at orders. So we're going to make this blue. And then for the fill, we're going to change this to from a white to a blue. So now when they see blue, they're going to, in their mind, see sales. And then we're going to create the second button. So now all we're going to do now is we're going to control C and we're going to select control V. And we're going to change this to orders. And for the color, we're going to select the maroon. Then we're just going to make one additional change. When we click on this total orders chart, we want to make this from the formatting options. We want to select from the columns, we want to make this maroon. So now blue is going to signal sales. Maroon is going to signal orders. Now you do not need to do this. This is just to make this really easy when we're showing you how to create these buttons on the different button stages. So now we've created the buttons. We've created the visuals. Now we need to just work on, we're going to close out this formatting option. And if you notice on the bookmarks, you've got show sales and you've got show orders. And now we're going to show you how to connect these with the button. We've created the buttons. We've created the visuals. Now we need to determine our bookmark. And these are what we call states, the hover states for the buttons. So when you have your sales button created, we have our orders button created, we have our sales chart, and we have our orders chart. So if we select our total sales chart, under the selection layer, total sales is now active. If we select the total orders, this moves up to total orders. So we're going to go back to total sales. And when we are showing total sales, we want to hide the total orders. So we're going to hide the orders visual. Now we want to add that bookmark. We're going to double click and we're going to call this sales. Next, we're going to go to the total orders stage. We want to show the orders visual. We want to hide the sales visual. And we want to add this stage. This is going to be called orders. So we have a sales stage where it shows sales. We have an order stage where it shows orders. So now we have a button that is not identified. So we added these two buttons, but we did not name them. We are going to name this orders button. We're going to double click and name this sales button. Next, we are going to connect the buttons to the different bookmarks. Continuing along on our report, we now have our selection. We have our bookmarks. We're going to close out this format button. If you click on the sales button and right click, you will see a formatting option. And this is where we are going to connect the sales state to the sales chart visual. And then we're going to connect the orders state, the orders button, to the orders visual. So currently on the sales button, when you go right click and format, your formatting options come up. You've got your size and style. You've got your title if you wanted to title that button. Instead, we want to choose the action. This is what we want it to do when we click on that button. If we turn that on and click the down arrow, we want it to be a bookmark. You've got all of these different options for the actions. You've got a back button, bookmark, drill through, page navigation, web URL. We are going to select bookmark. And we have two different bookmarks. We have the sales and then we have the orders. So we want to select sales. And that is all we want to do. Now when we go to the orders button, we want the action. We want to turn that on. We want to change that to a bookmark. And this one, we want to choose orders. So now that turns on that action. So now we have our buttons, we have our visuals, and we have our selections. So now when you choose Control plus click, you will see the sales chart and the orders chart goes away. When you choose the orders button, the orders chart visual comes up and the sales chart goes away. So those are the connections. So we have our selection, we have our bookmarks, and then we have our activation of that formatting on the button. And that only becomes active when the button is selected. That's when it gives you the options. So we're going to close that out. We're going to leave that on. And therefore, now when we just hit Control Sales, and then if we want to see orders, we can see the orders on the buttons. So again, as you start to work with your data visualizations and you're creating your reports, you want to create reports that are easy for the user to navigate. One final note as you start to plan out your buttons and changing visuals. For this example, we used a text box and created a blank button. But this could be an image or it could be a shape. So for example, you could quickly create a shape. It's named shape on the selection, and we'll call this sales shape. And what you would do is you would right click on this button, select format, and turn on the action. You would select your bookmark, which let's say we want to connect this to sales. Now it's connected. So we could have control click on orders and your orders shows up, and we could control click on this shape and we could have the total sales show up. So that is an example of using a button for rather than a text sales. That is a look at how to change a visual using a button in Power BI. As you've noticed, we just scratched the surface. We just took a quick basic look at how to create a button. But as you plan out your reports, there's lots of different options. You've got bookmarks, you've got different types of buttons, you've got formatting options. You can really design reports that are robust and they are working with the end user in mind. And you as the report designer get to dictate and design these reports. Remember, as you're designing your next report and creating your next data model, that you can use these bookmarks and buttons to navigate through your report.